Welcome back, YouTube. Jug here, and in this video, I'm going to be combining everything we've learned from my previous videos and put it all together into one big Abernathy tower. Not only does this tower go way over the size limit, but it also reaches the maximum height for Abernathy Farms. We're going to be working with a lot of difficult shapes and angles, not just on the exterior of the building, but on the interior as well. And as always, this will be done on the PlayStation, so no mods or console commands will be required. So let's get started. And here we are at Abernathy Farm, and this is probably the best place to build any kind of tall structure. It has the highest limit of any settlement in Fallout. And, you know, I'm going to go ahead and just jump ahead a little bit here and get a foundation down. If you saw my previous video, then you know exactly what I'm doing here. The floor I'm lining up here is actually just being lined up three planks off from the floor below it. I'm going to keep doing this around in an arc until it starts to look like a circle. But right now you can see that this next piece, I can just put it right up on top of that and just do it all over again. Three more planks, drop it down, and then just get rid of the rest of the floor. These floors will start to back up on you. Now if I move that piece out of the way, I can just drop that piece right back and put this back in place. And then eventually you'll get a nice arc just like this. As soon as you get all the unwanted pieces out of your way, we can go ahead and start switching these floors over into actual concrete or the shack foundations and get something that looks a little bit like this. I'll go ahead and take the stairwells and stack this up a couple more levels just so we can take a step back and see how it looks. But before we build this up too high, I want to take you back up top so I can show you how I'm doing my electric. I'm actually connecting all the wires and the connectors as I build. That way, as I drop concrete down on top of them, everything gets hidden and I don't have wires and connectors and all kinds of things dangling around in my hallways. Now I can take a small wood floor and then offset where I'm going to be snapping to by a half step. And that's what I'm going to do here just to create a cavity for our windows to sit in. Now before you stack any blocks on top of your connectors, go ahead and set one aside just like this, because if you block the connection, you're not going to be able to connect to it anymore. So that one is not going to get covered over there. I'm going to just leave it over there and then I can drag it up to the next level once I get there. As soon as we finish staggering these foundations, I'll go ahead and get rid of the stairwells, clean this area up just a little bit, and we'll take a step down and see what these window seals actually look like. This is really just a lot of tedious stacking. A lot of these pieces don't like to fit in place. Some of them fit really perfectly. I know a lot of you people at home, if you're making a lot of these buildings, you know exactly what I'm talking about. Sometimes you just gotta find that right spot and eventually it'll settle into place. But sometimes it takes a little while. We're going to start skipping levels here, but I don't want to go too far because I wanted to show you this level first because I've got a connector down already and it's already connected. So if I just pick this connector up, I can take it up to the next level and just drop it right on the concrete right above it and it won't have any trouble. I feel like it really helps to just put the lights in as you go. There were some circumstances where I missed a few lights and I had to go back and put the floors down to climb up there and get the lights in. And that's just not happening. That takes way too long. Just get your lights in as you're building. And I'm just building the foundation right up alongside with the lights too. So everything's just kind of going up all at once here on this front panel of the building. Taking a step back, we can see that these lights are starting to add a nice definition to the sides of this curve, but we still need to get the windows in place. So let's go back up top, and we're going to get the actual windows that go into these window seals. If you've seen my Coliseum build, you may have caught a glance at the windows in my power plant. These windows are going to be very similar, but instead of spending all the time to build around the light boxes, I'm actually just going to put them right on the edge of the concrete so that they stick out a little. I actually saw this done by another guy named Lunedog. He's a fantastic settlement builder, and I'll leave a link to his page in the description below. So I'm going to stack these 6 high, and the reason for that is that's exactly the amount of space it takes to fill up all of the concrete parts of a foundation block. So that's pretty much one level is 6 of these light boxes. And then if I just go through and connect all the backs of these with copper, it doesn't matter where these wires go. You can go side to side, diagonal if you wanted to. But as long as they're all connected, that's all that really matters. And then we can just connect each one of these sets of windows together so that they all are connected to the same power source. It's important that before we start stacking concrete on top of those light boxes, we need to go ahead and get the power connected to them because we won't be able to run the power to those light boxes through the concrete. Maybe we could. There might be a way, but I'm not going to try and figure it out. So let's just connect it first, and I'll just bring it down to the very bottom light box here. And then one more thing before we put the concrete in. We need to make sure we get some light because these light boxes don't give off any light. They look like they do. If you look at them from the front, they light up, but they don't shine on anything. They don't actually emit any kind of ambient effect. So we're just putting these lights in so we can see the light coming from the windows. And we've moved ahead a few more levels. I'm actually just filling in some of the walls as we move up this path. And we're going to need some more power generators. So let's get a bunch of these. I didn't mention this before about the power generators, but these will actually go right through the tops of these prefabs. And you can just reach the connector from the top side of these prefabs on the roofs. I should mention that before you start covering your windows with concrete, you may want to actually put some more lights down behind these light boxes, because just two was not enough. And I'm going to go ahead and step back, and you'll be able to see that light is only coming from one side of these windows, and I have to go back and fix that with rugs. So we've went quite a ways ahead, and if you look up top here, we got a lot more going on than we did. It's mostly just repetitive. I just went all the way to the top. But I do want to take you up to the top so you can see what I did with the back side of that arc. So all I've really done here is just continued the angle on the edges of this arc. And I've taken it all the way to the back so they kind of meet like a point. And we're just going to keep going up so I can give you a top-down view of what that might look like. I'm not going to be keeping these walls. They actually don't render from the ground level, so I just wanted to let you see this before we go down and start working on some of this trim around the edges of the arc. So I've had to remove a lot of these shack foundations in order to get this indention to run up along the sides here. Now, it probably would have been better to have done it as I was building, but, you know, a lot of times, a lot of you may know, you don't notice something needs something until you step back and you look at it, and this was one of those times. I just decided this needs more character to it. It needs more definition, and so that's what we did here. If you don't have enough lighting already embedded into your wall, you can still get lights in there just by placing a few rugs down on top of one another. Then you can place your light on top of the rug and then just select the first rug, and then everything else will just pass into the other objects. Now, the first time I saw this done was from a guy named Op Specialist. He's another fantastic settlement builder, and I'll leave his link in the description below. Now, the steps on this building are going to be far grander than the steps on my previous buildings. If you're unsure of how I've stacked these small wood floors, I recommend you go back and check out my Sanctuary Advanced Tips video. That'll explain how you can create a snapping tool and snap objects at any height. Now, once I have these small wood floors, I'm going to just use them as a guide and just snap these foundations into place, starting from the bottom and working my way up. It can be pretty difficult to fit some of these pieces in. You just got to have a lot of patience. But if you wiggle it around and maybe rotate it some and stand in different places, eventually you will get it. And if you don't, then that means there's something in the way. There's probably another wood floor that's blocking it, or you may just have something laying around that's getting in its way, just preventing it from snapping into place. Now, I have a TV here that I've just placed into the wall using some carpets. And I'm just going to go ahead and delete all these carpets. Or these are actually, I guess, floor mats but or welcome mats. See how that goes right back up? I don't know if everything does that, but I've seen a lot of objects do that when I've placed things in walls like that. I'm just going to go ahead and take a step back and get a better look at these steps, though. See how nice those steps look? But they're not finished. My feet are still getting hung up on these a little bit. So I'm going to put some rails or shelving right here on the edges. And this is going to help my feet make it up to the next level. And it's also just going to look better. I like the way that looks. It adds contrast to the dingy wood floor. And it goes along well with the concrete that goes underneath the floor. Now, if we go back inside, I want to show you the top part of this building. All it is really just lights that are going up the sides of the walls. And then I'm just stacking walls all the way up as we go. And if I come back down to ground level, we can get a good look at it. You can see there's a nice lighting effect that comes up through there. Of course, this is really plain on the back side. This isn't what we're going to finish with. So we're going to actually bring the sides out some to give it a little bit more detail and just do a few more things with the back side so the back just doesn't look so plain and straight. And again, we're just stacking foundations at different levels, and we're going to do the same thing to the other side. So if I just click on these, I can just, they'll go straight up to where my feet are. And I can just keep doing that every level, just using that as a bridge back and forth across this place. Now, once I get all this cleaned up, I can go ahead and get rid of all these stairwells. I want to go back down and show you what it looks like from the ground level on the back side of it. You can see that there's a nice texture going along the wall, and I've added a round surface on the back side of this wall. I just built that up, then held down X to pick up the whole object, and then just pushed it into place. So I pushed the center of these walls back a half step and changed them over to prefabs just so it didn't look so plain. Now I'm going to add lights to it to give it a little more definition. But before we do that, I want to go up top and show you what the outside of the top tower looks like. Now I'm only going to show one of these. I do this all the way up the sides of the buildings, but it would take a long time, and you get the idea just from doing one of these. So I'm just placing lights down right next to these newly placed prefabs on the sides of these walls, and it's just going to kind of highlight the indentation that goes up along the sides of the walls. And when I put these shack foundations back over top of them, it'll cover them up like it did with the other lights by the windows. What I'm doing here is just adding more definition to all these edges. And I could have put the lights inside the walls. But the reason I didn't do that is because I wanted it to be really bright. And, you know, you get the best effect off the lights if they're not inside the walls. So I'm going to do the same thing on the next level. And of course, I'll do that every level after that, all the way up the sides of these walls. But I'm only going to show two levels just to save time. And then we'll just take a step back and see what it looks like from back down on ground level. So here I'm just taking these containers and sticking them on top of these welcome mats. And on top of these containers are connectors. And the connectors are already connected with wires leading to each connector. And that's important that you already have those wired. And I'm able to move these right inside these poles here and then just delete all the other objects around the connector. And the connector will actually drop to the ground there. But the wire will stay put. It'll just stay right where it is. And you can get a nice rope railing effect from that. Now this was a pretty neat effect I was able to do by indenting these walls. Actually just by separating the shack foundations from one another. And I was able to just color coat these walls with light boxes. So not every hallway has this. It's actually every other hallway because of the offset shack foundations between the two hallways. I wasn't able to do the ones between these levels, but instead I just placed normal walls on those. So this is the grand hall of the entire building, and it was the most tedious room to make. I used the same circle method as before, but instead of using large floors, I used small floors. This makes the angles of the room much more seamless and smooth, giving a nice sharp circle near the ceiling. Now the problem with this room is that it takes up so much space that I actually had to completely rebuild the back of the building as well as extend it just to be much larger and be able to fit the entire circle around. Any Resident Evil fans out there? Now these lasers are kind of hard to see. I'm not sure if you can see them, but other than the lasers, these floors are not real floors. They're actually desks. And this was a little bit difficult to make, but I'm going to take a step back and let you see what I've done. So I tore out some of these walls so we could take a look under the hood. These lasers were stacked using multi-layered floors and welcome mats, and they're set to a longer delay than the light boxes, which are set to 1/8-second intervals. Well, not intervals, but you know what I'm saying. Each row of light box is separated by its own delay switch, so they'll go off at one after the other. And of course, these TVs are just there to add a sound effect. So it'll sound like power is coming on. And the, you know, the flamethrower is just there to spice up the whole deal. You can see from the side here that this is nowhere close to an actual floor. This is actually just a bunch of desks that I stacked really nicely up next to one another, putting the leg of the desk on these welcome mats and then just snugging them up against one another. And then there's just metal floor on the trim on the sides. So let's go ahead and go through this. And let's trip it this time, and let's see what it looks like. I haven't settled on a name yet, so for now I'm just going to call it Chapter 11, but I hope you found something useful that you can use in your own settlements. I want to thank all my subscribers. You guys have been great, very supportive. I hope this lives up to your expectations, and if you liked it, remember to hit that like button for me. I'm going to have something new here within the next couple weeks, so I'll see you guys then.